Okay, let's get started with the pre-lab assignment for experiment 9, chemical kinetics. You guys are working with a reaction mechanism this week. I've written here the step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. So I'm not going to use this reaction to work through the calculations. I'll use a different one, but the same principles will apply. You can note here that, for example, cyclohexanone I've represented with the letter A, so you don't have to draw it out every time you're doing the reaction. You can just use the letter A to represent that molecule, the same with B, C, D, E, etc. Also, you'll see that there are rate constants here for the forward reaction, K1, the reverse reaction, K-1, K2, K-2, etc. I'm going to use a different reaction to illustrate these principles. This is just a gas phase reaction, and it has three steps, and the overall equation is shown here. Notice again, we have these steps, and we have rate constants for the forward and reverse reactions. Now, what I'm going to do is work through this pre-lab assignment as if it were referring to this mechanism instead of the mechanism in your lab. So the first thing that we need to know in order to be able to do this is that our rate law is always going to be related to the slowest step or the rate limiting step. So I'll just write that down. So the slow step will give us our rate law. And the other thing that we need to know is that we can break these things down into what we call elementary steps. In other words, this first reaction, we can treat it as an elementary step, meaning that my rate law is expressed very simply. I multiply the rate constant times the concentration of the reactants raised to their stoichiometric coefficient. So the first question on my assignment asks, what would the rate law be if step one were the slowest step and the remaining steps were fast? So my slow step is correlated to the rate law, and I'm going to treat these as if they were elementary steps, meaning I use the stoichiometry of the reaction to determine the order of the reaction with respect to a specific reactant. And to start off, if step one is the reaction that's the slowest, then I say my rate equals K1 times the concentration of N2O5, that reactant, raised to its stoichiometric coefficient for the order of that reaction. And that's all, because step one is the slowest step. Now the second question here asks us, what do we do if step two is the slowest step and step one is in rapid equilibrium and the remaining steps are fast? So now step two is the slowest step, so following my rules from above, I'm going to have to write my rate expression here. Rate equals K2 times the concentration of N4O10, the reactant in my second step. Now, this is all fine and dandy, except there's some rules about this. And one rule is that we're not allowed to include intermediates in our final expression. An intermediate is something that is formed and then consumed during the course of the reaction. And we can see here that N4O10 is first formed in that first step, and then it's consumed in the second step. So we're not allowed to include intermediates in the expression. The second thing is, what does it mean exactly when it says it's in rapid equilibrium? And rapid equilibrium means that the rate of the forward reaction equals the rate of the reverse reaction. You may remember this just from your chemistry 106 class. The rate of the forward reaction equals the rate of the reverse reaction. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that information about step one, and I'm going to write an expression for the forward reaction. The forward reaction would be K1 times N2O5 squared, just like we did before. And now because it's in equilibrium, it's going to equal K-1 times N4O10, which is the rate of the reverse reaction. Now I have this fun expression and I can solve it for N4O10, which is my intermediate. When I do that, I get K1 over K-1 times N2O5 squared. Now I've solved for N4O10 and I can substitute that expression into my rate law. So doing that, I get rate equals K1, K2 over K minus 1 times N205 squared. And that would be my answer for step 2 were the slowest step. I'm not going to work through step 3. The same principles would apply as will in your experiment. We have to get our rate law from the slowest step, use elementary steps or the stoichiometry of the reaction to find the order with respect to each reactant, avoid including intermediates by using this rapid equilibrium, meaning the rate forward equals the rate reverse. That is all. Good luck with your pre-lab, and I'll see you in class. Thanks.